And what you'll see the alt-right do is adopt the beliefs of some of these other movements in order to find cover for their actual belief system, which really is quite vile.
Believes everything we do, but he doesn't call himself alt-right. They just can't wrap their heads around the fact that, like, marketing is important.
One particular lead influencer, when asked if having sex with a dog is the same thing as having sex with a black man, said, quote, they would both be degenerate. Really, really classy people.
You say that me having sex with my dog is the same thing as me having sex with a black man.
No. But they would both be degenerate.
Oh!
You suggested that a religious Catholic who writes for my website, a guy named Matt Walsh, is a, quote, Shabbos goy race traitor who is throwing his own people under the bus and hates white people.
Who cares? You know, enough with the Jim Crow stuff. Who cares? Oh, they had to drink out of a different water fountain. Big fucking deal. Oh no, they had to go to a different school. Their water fountain in that famous picture was worse. Who cares? You know, even if it was bad, who cares? Better. It's better in general. We all agree it was better for them. It's better for us. Better in general.
Some of them call themselves the new right and swear they despise the founders of the alt-right. Some call themselves America First, trying to hijack President Trump's slogan to give themselves the patina of credibility.
More way to get 2 million illegal immigrants a year here from Europe, I would say, let's do it. Let's do it. I don't care if they're paying taxes, not paying taxes. I don't care what they're doing. Get them over here, right?
So, when you believe all these garbage things, and you've said all these garbage things, and you are, in fact, a garbage human being, when your views are obviously white supremacist garbage, what do? You take four steps in order to legitimize yourself. Step number one, the Trump gambit. First, you declare your allegiance to President Trump, and declare that you're not really alt-right, even though you obviously are.
Let the adults talk, Donald. We don't need the exclamatory phrases, the borderline racist remarks. Now we need real candor.
You show up to lectures wearing a MAGA hat in order to get the media to cover it, and in order to demonstrate that you are truly a representative of the 63 million Trump voters. You call yourself America First, hijacking Trump's slogan. What you actually mean is white Americans first.
Will you? So are you going to, right now, are you going to denounce President Trump's policies on Israel? So are you MAGA hat wearers or not? So you guys, so the one issue you seem to care about is Israel. The one issue you care about, it's the only questions you've asked are about Israel. If the one thing you care about is Israel, then how does this make any sense?
Group. Okay, step two, then you declare yourself the true conservatives, the true heirs to conservatism.
What's happening? Here's what's happening here. This is the alt-right 2.0. You see, because the alt-right was discredited. So what they do is they try to cloak themselves in some sort of logical nationalism, some kind of MAGA hat wearing America First type rhetoric, which a lot of conservatives agree with. And then they use that to cloak their anti-Semitic leanings and their racist leanings. And it's pretty gross.
And then we have step three, which is to troll, right? You just show up at places like this and you say dumb things, then you tell all your friends how cool you are, and you tell edgy jokes about the Holocaust and cookies because, I mean, what could be funnier than that, obviously? I mean, that's just good stuff. And then finally, and this is the big one, you count on the left to help you out. Okay, I have one question. Are you protesting the part where I'm condemning the Nazis? Like, you hear what I'm doing right now. Do you have ears? I'm literally condemning Nazis, and you're telling me to leave. Do you
like if we shrank the suffrage, if we shrank enfranchisement in terms of the vote back to what it used to be, white property owning men,
retards, the real right is race mixing.
Plenty of people who disagree with me and who are critical of Israel and are not anti-Semitic. There are plenty of people who disagree with me on all the aforementioned issues. I've mentioned some of their names, and that is perfectly fine. If you want to discuss Nick Fuentes specifically, I suggest, again, you go back and you look at his videos. I suggest that you go back and you look at videos of him, actual videos of him, doing things like in which Nick Fuentes pulls out a switchblade and starts randomly jabbing it in the air while talking about me. No, I don't think he's a mainstream conservative, and I think that it's conflate mainstream conservatism with that kind of garbage. Thanks.